Hey, good morning, everybody. It's Andy here. Hope you're doing well today on this Wednesday afternoon. Just wanted to talk before we worship together. Wanted to talk a little bit about the garment of praise. Maybe you've heard of that in scripture. Maybe you've never heard what's a garment of praise. I remember when my dad, when I was younger, I was a pastor's son growing up my whole life. And one of the things I remember my dad saying to me was, when times come, like when you don't feel like praising the Lord, that's the time to do it. That's the time to like press in and actually praise the Lord through what you're going through. And what it does is it kind of shifts your focus, it shifts your perspective. And praise kind of works like a magnifying glass. It causes what you're focusing on to become bigger, to be magnified. David said, "Magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears." And it's a mistake until you have no problems, fewer problems, or your problems are solved before you even praise the Lord. Praise is one of the great scriptural keys to problem solving because it gets your focus on God, the problem solver. And Charles Spurgeon said this: "My happiest moments are when I am worshiping God, really adoring the Lord Jesus Christ. In that worship, I forget the cares of the church and everything else. To me, it's the nearest approach to what it will be like in heaven." And God has promised you the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. It works like this. When you begin to praise him with a heavy heart, you experience a new sense of hope and joy. And through worship, you're reminded that God is bigger than the situation that you face. He's not only capable of managing your concerns and your cares and worries, but he's willing and he's wanting to and he's waiting to do that. He's waiting to do that for you right now. So, and the psalmist wrote, "Seven times a day I praise you." So I want to encourage you today, fill your house with praise. Don't just take coffee breaks or couch breaks. Take some praise breaks today. And you know, there's two ways you can do this. Remind yourself of his attributes, you know, his power, his love, his grace, his goodness to you, and his acts. You know, recall his goodness in your life. So I'm encouraging you today, give you permission to go ahead, put on a garment of praise, and let's praise the Lord together.
Breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger. The King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder. The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You would lay down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Yes, we sing it. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory, who rules the nations with truth and justice, shines like the sun in all of its brilliance, the King of glory, the King above all kings.
This is amazing.
This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross, you would lay down your life, that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Yes, we want to sing what you've done for us. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy, worthy. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross, you would lay down your life, that I would be set free. You've done for me, all that you've done for me, all that you've done for us, Lord, all that you've done for me. Thank you, Lord.
Remind ourselves, Lord, of your goodness, of your great love, of your sacrifice, Lord. Lord, how worthy are you, Lord? Amen. Amen.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Yes, we do. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you.
Holy.
Holy, there is no one like you, there is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
Jesus.
Jesus, the name above every other name. just the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe, we live for you. Oh, we live for you.
Holy
and holy, there is no one like you. Oh, there is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill around me. Yes, Lord, lead us in your love. Oh, I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation. I will put my trust in you alone, and I will not be shaken. Oh, I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation. Oh, I will put my trust in you alone, and I will not be shaken. Holy, there is no one like you. Oh, there is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart. To those around us, Lord, to those who need your love. Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, oh, we live for you. Yes, we live for you.
Lord, with you is where we want to be, Lord. Our dwelling place, Lord, our firm foundation, the rock of our salvation, God. You never move, you never change. Always faithful, Lord. That's where we want to be, is in your arms, Lord, in your loving care. This is an older song I want to sing called Better Is One Day, and it comes from Psalm 84, and it says this: How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord Almighty. My soul yearns, even faints, for the courts of the Lord. In verse 10, it says, Better is one day in your courts 1,000 days elsewhere, Lord. Our heart and our flesh cry out for you, Lord, the living God, the one who can satisfy our souls.
How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord Almighty. For my soul longs and even faints for you. For here my heart is satisfied within your presence. I sing beneath the shadow of your wings. Better is one day in your coats. Better is one day in your house. Better is one day in your coats than thousands elsewhere. Better is one day in your coats. Better is one day in your house. Better is one day in your coats than thousands elsewhere. Than thousands elsewhere.
How lovely is your dwelling place?
How lovely is your dwelling place? O Lord Almighty, for my soul longs and even faints for you. For here my satisfied within your presence, I sing beneath the shadow of your wings.
Better is one day.
Better is one day in your courts. Better is one day in your house. Better is one day in your courts than thousands elsewhere. Better is one day in your courts. Better is one day in your house. Better is one day in your courts than thousands elsewhere.
My heart and flesh.
My heart and flesh cry out for you, the living God. Your spirit's water to my soul. I tasted and I've seen. Come once again to me. I will draw near to you. I will draw near to you. Lord, fill us up, Lord. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord Almighty, for my soul longs and even faints for For here my heart is satisfied within your presence. I sing beneath the shadow of your wings. Better is one day in your courts. Better is one day in your house. Better is one day in your courts than thousands elsewhere. Better is one day in your courts. Better is one day in your house. Better is one day in your courts than thousands elsewhere. Oh, better is one day. Better is one day. Better is one day, better is one day, better is one day, than thousands elsewhere, than thousands elsewhere.
Amen, Lord. Help us to dwell, Lord, in your presence. Help us to stay close to you, Lord. Help us to take some praise breaks today throughout the day, God. Help us to shift our focus and our perspective on something that's bigger and greater than any problem that we ever have, Lord. And that's Jesus. It's the Savior. Amen. Well, thanks for joining today, you guys. We will see you next week about the same time on all the social media platforms. So God bless you. Take care.